In a normal pain-free shoulder, there's enough room under your acromion for your rotator cuff tendons to slide when you move your arm. The tendons may pinch slightly, but this doesn't typically lead to pain. The more overhead activity you do, the worse your pain gets. The factors contributing to an impingement syndrome are repetitive overhead use, a hook on the end of your acromion. The larger your hook, the higher the likelihood of developing impingement. Also, bone spurs on the end of your acromion can cause impingement. Well, all three of these problems reduce the amount of space between the acromion and the humerus, causing impingement. Let's take a look at the symptoms of rotator cuff impingement and tendonitis and how they affect your daily life.
The two main symptoms of rotator cuff impingement are pain and stiffness. These symptoms develop over time depending on your age and activity level. The first symptom you'll develop is a nagging, persistent shoulder pain. That pain is often made worse when you use your arm above the shoulder level. Once you have pain, you'll start to limit the use of the arm to avoid feeling the pain. This is what causes the stiffness in your shoulder. The movements that cause you the most pain vary, but are generally ones that require you to reach above the shoulder level or reach behind your back. These movements can be broken down into several categories. The first is simple activities, such as reaching up into a cabinet, reaching into your back pocket for your wallet, or getting dressed can cause you pain. The second is work activities. Your job requirements can make your pain worse on a daily basis, especially if your job requires any repetitive overhead lifting, pushing, or pulling. The third is sports activities. Sports movements like repetitive overhead throwing or swimming can aggravate your symptoms. The last category is sleeping. Lying on a painful shoulder can cause you pain and wake you from sleep. Most people only seek treatment once their shoulder pain is bad enough or when the symptoms interfere with their daily lives. When I evaluate my patients for rotator cuff impingement, I want to know how long you've had the pain and how the pain interferes with your normal activities. In addition to the history of your symptoms, I also perform a physical exam to look for several specific findings. First is the location of your pain, which is often on the side of your arm and into your neck. Next, I'll check to see if your shoulder is stiff or stuck by evaluating your range of motion. And finally, I'll evaluate your shoulder for any weakness by testing the strength of the muscles in your shoulder.
Let's talk about what I call the shoulder pain cycle. When you have pain in your shoulder as a result of impingement and inflammation, you avoid using your shoulder. As you avoid using your shoulder, that is, you favor your shoulder, the shoulder scars down or gets stuck in the back. When this happens, the pain increases even more. Well, again, as the pain increases even more, you avoid using it even more. We get into a pain cycle, an increasing pain cycle, a cycle that we have to break with treatment. Breaking it with treatment means getting unstuck. Getting unstuck means getting yourself in the hands of a physical therapist. This is an X-ray of a patient with shoulder pain. Let's look at the parts list. This is the middle of the ball. This is the surface of the ball. This is the arm that is connected to the ball. The ball sits in the socket, which is at the end of the shoulder blade. This is the shoulder blade. Above the ball sit these two bones, the acromion bone and the clavicle or collarbone. And then in this space between the acromion bone and the top of the ball sits the rotator cuff tendon. This is the rotator cuff tendon. And it pulls in this direction. This patient has a bone spur that's pinching on the rotator cuff tendon. This bone spur is the source of pain and impingement in this patient. This is an MRI of this same patient with shoulder pain. Once again, let's look at the parts list. This is the middle of the ball. This is the surface of the ball connected to the arm. And up above, we have the acromion bone. Sitting between the acromion bone and the top of the ball is this black structure. This black structure is the rotator cuff tendon. This rotator cuff tendon is being pinched by this bone spur, causing pain and impingement.